And then in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your streaming on a YouTube using the Prism Live Studio, which is a live streaming and video production software that you can use to cover up your event and also record your video production. I'm going to show you how to set up your streaming on YouTube using this new software. Okay, without any further ado, let me show you how to set up your streaming on a YouTube using the Prism Live Studio. Okay, so the first thing you are going to do is go ahead and download this software. You can see right here. So I've also dropped the link in the description below. Go ahead, click on the link and download it. Okay, so once you're done downloading it, install it. So once you install it, sign up using your email or your Yahoo mail address. So whichever one you want to use any of it and sign up. You can also use your Facebook, your Twitch account, use them and sign up on the Prism Live Studio. And once you sign up, you're going to be looking at this beautiful dashboard you are seeing right here. And in case if you're confused, I've also done a couple of other videos on this my YouTube channel. You can check them out on how you can make use of this new software. Okay, now once you're here, you bring in your video feed. The next thing you're going to do is go over to custom RTMP server. So we're going to be making it two ways, using the normal YouTube login and also the custom RTMP server. So we're going to be doing the two method, which is what I'm going to be showing you in this particular video. Now first, let's try the custom RTMP server before we go over to logging into our YouTube account. Okay, so I always advise using the custom RTMP server. Okay, that is because you won't be sending your information to anybody or having to enable them access to your channel or anything. So it's best you use the custom RTMP server. But nevertheless, I'm still going to show you how to also log in using the login method as well. Okay, so click on the custom here, custom RTMP server. And from here, URL, just click on it and select YouTube. Now, once you've selected YouTube, go over to here. Maybe your channel or anything you want to stream on, click on it and go over to YouTube Studio. So see the YouTube Studio there, and I'm going to open the YouTube Studio. So I'm just going to give it a moment for it to load, and once it has finished loading like this, click on the create button and you see the go live there. So click on the go live, and once you're on the go live, make sure it's on stream, not on webcam. Oh, you see, if it's on webcam, it means you want to use your webcam to stream. So, but if it's on stream, it means you want to use a third-party software. Now, once you're here like this, you can just click on the edit, set your title or your title, your description, whichever one you want to make use of. You can set all of that here. And once you're done with this, go ahead and copy the stream key. See the stream key here, this one. Go ahead and copy it. And once you've copied that, go back to the software and paste the stream key here. Don't be confused, you are not typing any ID or password. This is just what you need. It's as simple as that. And once you've put in your stream key, go ahead and save it. Okay, go ahead and save it. And if you want to add other platforms to it, all you have to do is click on this three dot line here and select add channels. You see, add channels, and see the YouTube here, select it. Okay, and you're going to allow access to that particular YouTube Gmail, and from there you allow access to your YouTube channel, and it's going to pop up here also as well. So I'm not going to do that because I don't want to give them access to my YouTube channel. So if you want to do that, that is all you have to do. Click on the Gmail account you used on your YouTube channel, and from there allow access to your YouTube account, and it's going to display here. And once you're done with all of this, go ahead and click on the setting sign here. So for us to set up our streaming video quality and everything, click on that setting sign down here and click on output. Now on the output, scroll down, you are going to see streaming. See on the streaming there, that is the video bitrate you are seeing right there on the screen. Then you can set the video bitrate to any amount you like, but I advise you use the speedtest.net to verify your internet upload and download speed. Now once you find out your download and upload speed, it will give you a clearer picture on the amount of video bitrate you should use for your live stream. So if you use a higher number that is more than your internet upload speed, you are going to fix a lot of problem with it because it's going to lag. Okay, so I'm going to reduce my to a lower number. That is because I'm using my phone hotspot. Okay, so I'm going to reduce it to 500, and that is it. Now from the encoder, if you're using a dedicated graphics PC, you can select that here, but if not, you can just leave it on the software to reduce the load on your CPU. okay, and then the audio bitrate, you can set it between 96 and 128, between any of this number. Okay, now once you're done with that, click on apply and okay. And once you've finished everything, just click on the go live button there and you'll be live on YouTube. Okay, so once I click this now, okay, your broadcast is streaming properly via YouTube. See, I should check if my streaming properly via YouTube, and you're going to see it live here on YouTube. You can see I'm currently live. This is going to load. I see I'm currently live here on YouTube. So I'm just going to cut this off because I set it on public. Okay, so finish. And that is how to set up your streaming on YouTube using the Prism Live Studio. Now, another thing also is that when you go live and your network start fluctuating, you get this alert stuff here. So this alert tab here is where they give you all the messages. If your frame rate drop, if your internet is bad, you also get messages here, just like the one you saw now. So get messages here so that you can also work on it or change the internet or probably upgrade your internet or anything. You get to see all the alerts here. So they will inform you, they will show you everything, your frame rate when it's dropping and when it's high, when it's okay and when it's not. So you get that here on the alert. So once you click on the alert here, you're going to see all of it, okay? And that is how to use this software to set up your streaming on YouTube. Remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete this video before people start watching it, because before they start coming to it, I'm just going to go ahead and end it. Okay, end it and then delete it. Just 1 second, please. So I don't want them coming to see it. But this is actually a test that we did. See, one person already liked it. You see? So I'm just going to go ahead and delete it before they come to it to watch it. And that is it, guys. Thank you very much. And remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel.